In order to further understand yield and selectivity, we will go through straightforwardly to an example. I use the similar reactions with the example in the extent of reactions classes. So in this example, there's two reactions. One is methane and oxygen producing carbon dioxide. Another one is methane and oxygen producing carbon monoxide. So given in the question is the inlet flow rate of methane and oxygen, and also the outlet flow rate of all products. Okay, methane, oxygen, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and water. So what will be the percentage yield of carbon dioxide, and also the selectivity of carbon dioxide compared to the carbon monoxide? We know the general equation of yield. So how do we want to translate with the example? So number of mole of desired product form. So in this case, our desired product is carbon monoxide. Okay, another indicator to understand it, you need to check on the reaction number one, the first reaction, what is the products. So carbon dioxide is the product, so that is how we know that that is the desired product being formed. Okay, so divide by the number of mole of CO2 produced if no side reaction occur. So if no reaction 2, okay, we assume only reaction 1 occur, and the limiting reactant, if you have two substances here, so you need to know which one is your limiting reactant. Okay, is 100% converted into your product, which is CO2. So this is the simplification of the equation. So number of CO2 being outlet. Okay, so in this case, carbon dioxide outlet is 10 mole per second. Divide by the maximum carbon dioxide being formed. So the limiting reactant for the inlet compared to oxygen, the limiting reactant is methane. Okay, because in terms of stoichiometry, oxygen is in the excess form. So we assume that all 25 mole of methane converted into carbon dioxide in reaction 1. Okay, so number of mole of methane inlet times with the stoichiometry coefficient of CO2 in reaction 1, which is 1 here. So that's why I put 1 here. And divide by the stoichiometry coefficient of methane in reaction 1, which is 1 here as well. So you know that the maximum carbon dioxide being formed is 25. Translate all the informations into equations. So you get 10 divided by 25 is equivalent to 0.4. 0.4 is the fraction form, fraction yield. Okay, so the question requested for percentage. So you times with 100, then you get the percentage or yield of carbon dioxide. Now we move to the selectivity of CO2 to carbon monoxide production. So this is the general equation of selectivity. So number of mole of desired product. Desired product is carbon dioxide. So the outlet molar flow rate of carbon dioxide, 10, divided by the number of mole of undesired product, in this case carbon monoxide. So flow rate of the carbon monoxide, which is 8. So 10 divided by 8, then you get the final answer for this example.